Well, the question we want to consider is how will large language models, generalized pre-trained transformers, or GPTs, impact cybersecurity? And who should we ask? I'd like to go to the future, and I'd like to ask someone who already knows the answer. And I may as well ask my namesake, Una Chin Riley, but she actually wasn't available. That season's not out yet. So instead, you've got me. And I'm a 21st century contemporary researcher here at MIT. I have a generation, if you'll excuse the pun, of experience in machine learning. And lately, my group has been doing a lot of work in applying machine learning to cybersecurity. So how am I going to answer this question? I'm going to give you the bottom line up front. I think that LLMs, with their support, will be rapidly taken up by ambitious and talented global enterprises that will design by application developers who are going to produce better tools, faster tools, and smarter tools and services for the defense side of things. And these tools are actually going to be very impressive. They're going to be naturally intuitive. They're going to be more automatic and improve our use of manual effort. And they're going to reason so impressively compared to where AI has brought us before. So what this is going to help is this environment in the Security Operations Center, which is almost adrenaline soaked, because it has to handle detection and responses for these threats that are coming in very, very rapidly. And we need to do this because, of course, the same uptake and help that we gain from LLM-supported improvements to our defensive security tools and services is inevitably going to be taken up by the adversaries on the other side of the fence. The alleviation we will get from LLMs is going to be matched by the aggravation that we get from them. What we're going to see from threat actors is threats that will tie us in knots, that will have additional speed, that will be more relentless, and that will be even smarter than before. So let me elaborate. But wait, actually, I'm going to stop myself. Because the original question was, who should we ask? Right? And come on, here I am. Who do you think we should ask how LLMs will influence cybersecurity? It's obvious, right? Let's ask GPT-4. Right? So in preparing my talk, I was chatting with a postdoc, Steve, in my group. And he said he had just asked GPT-4 a similar question. So I'm going to give you a view of the interaction that Steve prepared. And I should say, before I show you the prompt, that I consider Steve to be a prompt whisperer. He's been working with my group for over 6 months on supporting cybersecurity threat actor modeling and threat defenses using LLMs. And he knows the magic that it takes. And when I show you this prompt, you might see some of that, because it's a little bit wordy. And that's because, remember, LLMs are general purpose. And if we want to have them do something for us, then we need to give them context and point them to the topic we want them to give us a response. So here's the prompt. You're participating in a roundtable discussion. You'll be prompted with cybersecurity questions related to AI. You are to respond to the prompt and answer appropriately. Make your responses concise and direct. Do not mention that you're an AI language model. And your responses should sound in the tone of an opinion. So, in what ways can LLMs help alleviate or aggravate cybersecurity problems? So this is the response we got. I've taken the first line and I've made it the title of my slide. GPT-4 gave me a list of alleviations and aggravations, and I've just put them side by side verbatim on the slide for you to see. I don't expect you to look at their detail. What I want to tell you is that under the alleviation column, it hit everything I said or was planning to say. And under the aggravation column, maybe not so good. There's two things that correspond to my mention of the defense and the offense being correlated. But this item about disinformation campaigns is out of scope. And the item about adversarial attacks, if you study it a little bit, it's off base. So being an academic, if I want to grade GPT-4 on this response, it gets a C. That's satisfactory. I would call it satisfactory because it's startling with respect to how much better it is than current technology. And I think that's part of the factor. We appreciate it. But as we use these models more and more, that startling impact is going to go away. And I think we'll see other things. I will remark that it's incredibly convenient because I had all these ideas in my head and asking the model ordered them, itemized them, you know, and actually reassured me that my ideas were consistent, right? But if you start looking at these a little bit more probingly, I think what you'll find is that they become rote. And I'd like to say that they're shallow, the responses. And that's because the model is not reflecting any sort of causal understanding of what it is in LLMs that give rise to these alleviations and aggravations. And when it has alleviations and aggravations, how I connected them, it doesn't do that because it doesn't reflect any causal understanding of their relationship. The last point I want to bring up is the most important, which is this has lured us into a sense of confidence that we have the whole thing covered. But I had more things on my list beyond my bluff, and I'm going to tell you the ones that GPT-4 didn't mention. So first, my team and I are working on cyber hunting. And cyber hunting starts from a lot of text and code knowledge that's out there on the internet that's being compiled from cyber threat experience and by our governments. And it basically looks for threat actors in a system before they're detected. So it actually ups the defensive game by being a little bit more anticipative. And this is one thing that you would expect GPT-4 to think about. Right? It has actually trained on all that data I'm referring to. And yet it hasn't given me that answer, right? And I think there's one more thing I can mention, which is that when I connect aggravation and alleviation, there's another important impact, right? The current pace of our cyber arms race is going to be disrupted by LLMs. Consider our current defenses. That's on the y-axis here. They range from being very strong, well-resourced, to unfortunately being weaker, perhaps out of date. And they face off with threat actors that range in low competence, middle-aged competence, these are the ransomware people you really worry about, and then state actors who have tremendous resources and are actually operating on a different level. So there's a cyber arms race between the defenses and the threat actors currently. What the LLMs are going to do is they're going to float those boats higher, right? Now, you would say, okay, defenses are too. But what's important here is how fast each side works, which gives them the right to getting to the top and staying at the top, the fastest and the longest. And this is a problem that we all have to be concerned about. It's missing something else, the answer from GPT, which is any acknowledgement that things are unknown and an ability to think about the unknown. GPT-4 hasn't given any credit to the sauce of humanity, including a dash of creativity, ingenuity, serendipity, and emergent thought processes, anything that provides the potential for novelty. So to summarize, from our answer from today, not the future, we know that LLMs will alleviate and aggravate. That's GPT-4 level answer. But beyond that, we can expect better cyber hunting and a rather worrisome arms race with a dash of the unknown. Thank you.